A very good morning to all of you. Let us continue the chapter 4 of civics, key elements of a democratic government. Today we will study about need to resolve conflict. India is a country of diversity. People belonging to different castes and religions have found here. Generally, people of lower caste are socially and economically backward. They are at loggerheads with people of upper castes. Though majority of Indians are Hindus, people following Islam, Christianity, Buddhism, Jainism and Sikhism have lived and prospered for centuries. Besides, there are other sects and subsects. Out of this, 32 languages are spoken by more than 1 lakh people. The government has recognized 22 languages as official languages. Majority of people in North India speak Hindi, whereas those in South India speak Tamil in Tamil Nadu, Kannada in Karnataka, Malayalam in Kerala, and Telugu in Andhra Pradesh. Apart from those differences, we have regional imbalances in development. Generally speaking, northwestern and southern states of India are more developed than the eastern states. Therefore, conflicts and tensions are natural in Indian society. Caste and religious conflicts are most common. Let's learn by examples. When the government decided to reserve 27% of jobs for other backward classes, caste conflicts broke out. People belonging to upper caste and lower castes organized demonstrations, processions, and public meetings for and against the order of the government. Eventually, the Supreme Court intervened and stayed the decision. After a few years, the Supreme Court gave a verdict in favor of OBC reservation. Thus, we find here that the highest court of our country resolved the conflict. Religion is also important matter for conflicts. One community sometimes do conflict with others. The route of a procession of Hindu might pass through a Muslim dominated locality and vice versa, or a Durga Puja procession might pass through a Muslim dominated area. A Muharram procession or Tazia might proceed through a Hindu dominated area. In such cases, communal passions arise and flare up. Here, the police organize a meeting of elders of both the communities, discuss various issues and appeal them to maintain peace. The administration has the responsibility to maintain law and order. Now let us see equality and justice given by our constitution. It is the duty of a democratic government to provide equality and justice to all its citizens. As the preamble to Indian Constitution provides, we secure to the all its citizens justice, social, economic and political equality of status and of opportunity. There are various provisions in our Constitution against discrimination and inequality. The fundamental rights given in the Constitution guarantees justice and equality to all citizens. As we know, untouchability is now abolished. Any discrimination or even a derogatory comment against Dalit is a punishable offense. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, the chief brain behind the Indian Constitution, had himself faced shocking discrimination that you studied in the earlier chapters. He realized the necessity of giving social justice. All citizens are equal in the eyes of law. Law gives equal protection to all without any discrimination. The constitution has abolished all titles like Sir, Rai Bahadur, etc. that were conferred during British rule. There is discrimination against girls and women in our society. Parents desire the birth of a male child more than that of a female child. A girl is given less care and attention in the family than a boy. This is called gender discrimination. The government has enacted various laws to give justice and equality to women. There is also talk of women empowerment. They have been provided 33% of seats in panchayat posts. There are laws to stop the practice of dowry. Recently, women have been given the right of inheritance in their parents' property. The government is considered to reserve a fixed percentage of seats for women in panchayat. It is also the duty of citizens to sow the seeds of tolerance and brotherhood. Everything cannot be left to the law and the administration or the government. It is our responsibility to see that caste and religious conflict don't arise in society. So that's all for today. The chapter is over. In the next class, you will do the exercises. Thank you. Have a good day.